Dolphins Show. My name is Tifa. I have the pleasure of being your host for today's presentation, but more importantly, I get to introduce the true stars of the show. So if you guys aren't ready, let's get moving. Welcome to our teenager of the group. This is 19-year-old Cosmo.
Warmer layer will start to get thinner.
But it is a little difficult to see when our stars are in the water, so let's invite one of them out of the water to get a better view of all that water. We'll be doing a training demonstration for everyone today to give you all a sneak peek of what it takes to train a dolphin. One of the first behaviors our dolphins learn is simply called aim to target. That target behavior is where we ask the dolphin to touch their bottom of the feet to the flat palm of a trainer. And then from that target, we can start moving it around to build a behavior. So for example, that target can move up and down for head shake of yes, and even side to side for head shake of no way. But for our training purposes, we're going to be utilizing a target to bring Chopper up on stage in a behavior called a slide out. Now what we're looking for is that Chopper is going to receive a hand signal or a hand target. And we're looking for him to come all the way up stage and make full contact with the trainer's hand. And then simply by coming up on stage, we're looking for him to also bring his glutes out of the water and kind of flex them upward towards the sky. Demonstrating right now. Now what we're also looking for in this behavior is that he's able to allow a trainer to touch on his side and simply turn him on the dock. And this right here can be used in husbandry or healthcare behaviors, such as simply transport or even during ultrasound and x-rays when we may need to get a better angle on the dolphin for health reasons. But Chopper's doing an excellent job demonstrating what it takes to do training so far, but how does he know when he's correct? Well, we can use either simply a double tap touch on his skin to let him know that he was correct. And by that, we can use these whistles around the trainer's neck to actually audibly tell him that he was correct. And then we can simply reinforce the behavior with fish from the bucket, toy play, or even social interactions from the trainer in the form of a belly rub or back rub. But now how does Chopper know when he is incorrect on what we're looking for? Well, this right here is actually a perfect example. The slide out that Chopper is doing, he didn't quite come up and make contact with the trainer's hand, so we simply provided him with a short pause and provided no information, simply to let him know that what he did was not correct. But here we are doing the behavior again, and this time he is correct, allowing the trainer to touch on his back and also came up and make contact with the trainer's hand. All of those are the correct steps for this behavior. Now, of course, when learning a new behavior for us, it can take us a certain amount of time to learn something new. And the same thing is also correct for our dolphins. It can simply take them weeks, months, and years to fully master all the steps of a new behavior until it is completely correct. And during that training process, we can provide them with as much information as they need. So with this behavior, we're looking for Chopper to also come up straight onto the dock instead of coming up at a slight angle or slightly sideways. And he's doing a good job at this attempt here by allowing the trainer to feed him, but also allow a second trainer to make contact on his back and his tail. So let's go ahead and give Chopper a big round of applause as he demonstrated this new learning skill. And as you can see again, Chopper is completely trusting the trainer and even allowing them to feed him while he's up here on stage instead of being fed in the water. But then when he is actually getting that verbal whistle telling him he was correct, he's getting more reinforcement right there as well. But that was a great demonstration for training on a dolphin and going over the steps of targeting and how that is the first step or behavior for all of our training here. So now let's go back to talking about the dolphin and the adaptations that they need to survive a watery environment. It happens to be all their fins and flippers. That was a really fast look at all those fins and flippers, so let's go over them in more detail, starting with the fin on the dolphin's back. This is called a dorsal fin, but it has no bone at all. It is entirely made up of cartilage dolphin step. And also that dorsal fin is unique for every individual dolphin. So it actually is one of the best ways to identify a dolphin. So I actually challenge everyone in our audience to see if you can tell the difference between our dolphins by using only their dorsal fin alone. And I said flippers instead of fin because these do have bone and are actually made up of 5 bony digits, just like our hands and feet. But it's also we'll use them for going ahead and giving our trainers a cool high five and even looking over at our audience and waving hello. But those pectoral flippers are most perfect for all their lightning quick stops and their sudden turns. Flukes. And I said flukes plural because there's two of them connected in the center by what's called a median notch. And then, of course, that tail fin connects to the powerhouse of the dolphin, which is also called their peduncle. And that's a strong muscular area that they use in a hunting technique called a tail lock, which is where they simply will flap their flukes so hard on the surface of the water that they're able to stun their fish prey, so it's much easier to gobble it right up. In addition, that peduncle is so powerful, it allows dolphins to reach swim speeds of over 20 miles an hour, making it much easier to get up and out of the water for a better view of all their surroundings.
Do what's called a blood layout.
Now all we're doing is asking them to bring up their tail and stay nice and calm while we actually feel around on the veins in their tail. But although we're not taking the blood sample itself every day, we can do the behavior every day so that it remains positive with our dolphins. But now, I'm curious. We're having an opportunity with our dolphins today, so can we give them anything to let them know that they're good? A fish sounds like a great idea. It happens to be one of their favorite things. But Melody, you're our expert on stage, so can you let the audience know what kind of fish you're holding? A silverfish, that is a very accurate way to describe it. It is indeed silver. But the answer we're looking for is actually just a dead fish. It is still one of our dolphins' favorites. So go ahead and play it. Awesome job. But Molly, we have one more question for you. What do your hands smell like? Oh, they smell like fish. Well, it's okay. We have an easy way of cleaning hands. So let's go ahead and follow what our trainer does. Put your hands up in front of you and clap them together. Rub them really fast to get those skills loose. Wave them in the air to get them all dry. And the best part is you wipe them on your clothes. And then you can tell your friends and family that that fishy smell will come out of your cute dress in about 2 to 3 weeks. But as okay, let's give Zeke and Ellie a big round of applause. Well, as you can see, the overall health and well-being of our dolphins is priorities here at the Gulfarium. But we're not just concerned about our own residents, but also their ocean counterparts as well. Many people don't realize it's illegal for us to interact with marine mammals in their natural environment. And this includes all marine mammals, such as dolphins, but even whales, manatees, seals, and sea lions as well. This is for both our protection and theirs, since disrupting their natural behavior can lead to the separation of mom and calf pairs, unintentional boat strike injuries, and unintentional catching and fishing equipment. So we ask that we still admire these amazing marine mammals, but that we all do it as heroes from a safe and respectful distance.
Jump on, Mama.
on behalf of myself, our trainer, and the